Most people have heard the term a heart murmur. I first came across it before as a doctor when I heard someone wasn't able to enroll in the army because of it. At the time, I didn't know what it was, but I'm here today to tell you all about what a heart murmur is. Hello, it's Dr. Hope and welcome to Sick Notes, where we jargon bust medical terms. Today, we're talking about heart murmurs. A heart murmur isn't a diagnosis. It simply means that a doctor, when listening to the heart, can hear the blood flowing through it. Usually, blood flows through the heart in a smooth way, so cannot be heard. For example, if water was flowing through a nice straight pipe, we're not necessarily going to hear it. Yet if that pipe had a kink in it, it's likely to disrupt the flow and so cause turbulent water within the pipe and therefore making a noise. So it's quite simple. A heart murmur is caused by something disrupting the normal blood flow through the heart. So what can cause this disruption to flow? Well, the heart is a beautiful muscular pump with four chambers that blood go in and out of. There are valves on the exit to each of these chambers to stop blood flow in the wrong direction. So I basically described the three things that can cause a murmur: the valves, the muscular wall, or specifically a hole in the muscular wall, and the last one is a bit of a cop-out, we call it a functional murmur, where the heart itself is normal, but the blood is flowing more rapidly through the heart. So let's talk about murmurs caused by heart valves. The normal sound of a heart, the lub-dub, lub-dub sound, is caused by the valves closing. So think of the valves like a one-way door. They let blood through one way, but not through the other way. And so there's two things that can go wrong with this door. It cannot fully open, or it cannot fully close. Both of these will cause turbulent blood flow. When the valve becomes stiff and doesn't fully open, we call this stenosis, from the Greek narrow. And when the valve doesn't fully close, we call this regurgitation, or insufficiency, because the blood is going to flow back through the valve in the wrong direction. Both stenosis and regurgitation cause a disruption in the blood flow, therefore turbulent blood flow within the heart, and therefore will cause a heart murmur. So on to problems with the muscular wall of the heart. The central muscular wall of the heart is called the septum, and it separates the left-hand side of the heart with the right-hand side of the heart. If there's a hole within the septum, blood will flow from one side of the heart to the other side of the heart, and this will cause disruptive flow and therefore also cause a murmur. Holes in the heart are most likely present from birth. Finally, functional murmurs, or innocent murmurs, or sometimes called physiological murmurs. This is where the heart itself is normal, but the blood is flowing more rapidly through the heart. So think of our water pipe example. This is where more water is being forced through the pipe, therefore creating some turbulent flow and therefore creating a murmur. These murmurs still warrant investigating, even though they're called innocent, because they can very rarely be caused by things like thyroid problems and anemia. These murmurs can also be present at pregnancy, where the blood volume increases to support the baby. So I hope this has helped your understanding of heart murmurs. I've put some clarifications and some further links in the description below. This is my first video, but please feel free to subscribe. Hopefully there's some more videos on my channel by now. Have a good day.